The S-Class is without a doubt the indisputed champion of the full-size sedan segment, and for a good time they had no competition at all. But the introduction of the 7 Series changed things a lot. And so both brands started a war, trying to build the best car possible. And this culminated in the late 80s, when both Mercedes and BMW were developing the generation of the 90s. In 1985, BMW presented the E32, the second generation 7 Series. And the car was on another level compared to the rest, and definitely set the rules for the future. But the most important thing was the introduction of the V12 engine in 1987. Until that point, V12s were mostly reserved for exotics, except Jaguar, which had been using V12s on their top-of-the-line models for years. But the M70 was a much more modern engine, and even scared Mercedes, which decided to delay the presentation of the W140 by 18 months in order to build a new V12 engine, and also to rearrange the engine bay in order to accommodate a V12 engine. And the V16 project started as a way to see how far things could go. BMW started developing their V16 in 1987, and by 1988 the engine was ready. It was based on the M70, just with 4 additional cylinders. In the end, this monster had a capacity of 7,751cc, could produce 405 horsepower at 5,200 rpm and 450 pound-foot of torque at 3,900 rpm, and had a massive curb weight of 310 kilos. In fact, the engine was so big that BMW had to put the radiators on the trunk, since there was no space under the hood. Mercedes also started developing their V16 around the same time. Now, this is a way more mysterious project, but it's believed that Mercedes started developing it as a response to BMW. Nobody knew at the time if BMW would put the V16 engine into production, so Mercedes wanted to be prepared. Since the M120 had a displacement of 6 liters, the V16 engine ended up having a capacity of 8 liters, producing 540 horsepower. Now, as we know, these engines were never put into production, and there are so many reasons for that. First, the engines were just too big for the engine bay, even if the cars were designed with the V16 in mind. Another reason is that they weren't that powerful. The M120, for example, on its standard version produced 400 horsepower, while the 7.3 liter of AMG, Brabus and of the rest of the tuners could easily top 500 horsepower. But the final nail on the coffin were the environmental regulations that came in the early 90s, which pretty soon would also kill the V12s of both BMW and Mercedes. But an even crazier project would start in the mid-90s, when Mercedes was looking to bring back the Maybach name, and they saw the possibility to build a V24. By welding two V12s together, but this project never went past the drawing board.